Bonjour.
Hello.
Les cyclones tropicaux, aussi
tropical hurricanes, also called typhoons, are among the most devastating atmospheric events. They form if some conditions are met: ocean temperature, instability, humidity and wind in the troposphere, and the existence of a rainy storm and a sufficient distance from the equator. They can therefore develop only on some ocean basins during the summer of each hemisphere. In each of those basins, the World Weather Organization has appointed a special center. For the Southwest Indian Basin, Météo France in the Réunion Island is in charge of monitoring the typhoons. They can cause considerable damage because wind, rain and the sea are combined. Wind is concentrated around the wall and damages buildings, infrastructures and networks. Heavy rain is located in the eye and around the stripes. They will cause landslide, floods and destruction. And there will also be storms and tidal waves on the coast, changing the shape of the coast and the systems along the coast. Human casualties and environmental damage can be devastating. Cyclone rains in some areas are also a water resource which is absolutely essential for human life. In a context where climate is changing, we must assess the past and future evolution and the conditions in which this kind of hurricane or typhoon is generated. The typhoon activity is variable because it is modulated by atmospheric currents and events such as El Niño. But it is also impacted by global warming and anthropic activity. Detection of changes in the behavior of hurricanes in the past is limited by the availability of databases and their consistency. It is difficult to go back beyond 30 years when satellites were invented, with a single exception, the North Atlantic area, because recon flights were organized as early as the 1940s. For more than 50 years, the uncertainties connected with the changes in the observation capacities do not allow us to have a robust trend. Over the last 20, 30 years, scientific studies have generated reliable trends. On the global level, the number of tropical typhoons is relatively constant, 90 a year, and the migration of the maximum intensity is moving towards the pole, probably due to tropical expansion due to climate changes. In the North Atlantic basin, the frequency of the most intense hurricanes has increased, possibly due to regional forcing, due to aerosols and greenhouse effect gases. In the Southwest and in the Indian Ocean basin, in yellow we have the number of storms and in red the number of hurricanes and the normalized, standardized abnormality of typhoon energy in the southwest of the Indian Ocean does not show any specific trend over the basin. In order to understand the future evolution of hurricane activity considering the global warming, we base ourselves on the results of climatic projections or simulations based on several models with different scenarios of greenhouse effect gas emissions. Because the resolution is of models is too low, we used an index of cyclogenesis in order to perform our work. Here, the CYGP index is based on large-scale parameters, wind sharing, vorticity, and convective rainfall, which play a more or less direct role in typhoon formation. Then we will deduct a number of tropical typhoons from this calculation. And the fifth IPCC report concludes that the number of tropical typhoons will decrease or remain stable, but maximum wind and typhoon rainfall should grow. The impact of the climatic changes on tropical hurricanes will vary from one region to the next. Take the example of the southwestern part of the Indian Ocean. In 2080, the average of the zonal winds calculated with several models shows a positive abnormality of zonal wind in the tropical area, and the meridian wind abnormality on the Mozambique Canal is due to a slowdown in the monsoon flow. By combining the two trends, there could be an impact on the convergence intertropical area and therefore hurricane activity. Now, general questions must be raised, and they are still open and unanswered. On the territory level, the problems are addressed in a more concrete way. Take the Mascarene archipelago. Some questions will influence regional policies for the next few decades. Urbanization along the coast, is this going to increase the cost of typhoons? And also acidification and temperature rise in the oceans, is this going to destroy the coral reef and prevent it from playing its protective role? And finally, drought. Are typhoon rains going to be able to compensate for the increased number of droughts in the austral areas? Territories impacted by typhoons will need to adjust. And adjust from being and change from being a territory adjusted to the current climate conditions to future climate conditions. Now, this is only an amplification of existing problems, and therefore the first efficient stage would be a more efficient management of the current situation. Managing the typhoon risk is based on three phases: prevention, crisis management, and damage payment. We need to have a look at the construction rules to protect ourselves against the typhoons and also control better land planning and prevent events such as landslides. Typhoons must be monitored with actual observation but also models, and by increasing the intensity of observation in areas where there is not enough monitoring taking place and by improving the digital prediction models, we will be able to anticipate earlier the intensity, the path followed by the typhoons, and prevent the causes indirect and direct. In order to better adapt the territories affected by typhoons to the climate changes, the scientific community must structure itself around integrated project research projects and also ask for help from the local administrations. The idea is to predict future typhoons, their intensity, and the impact they are going to have on the populations, the infrastructures, the economy, and the environment. The results of the study will be a decision-making tool for local players so that they can implement a land planning policies that will optimize the economic costs. Reducing vulnerability and improving adjustment will be something that will be done individually by each territory, depending on the geography, the existence of large towns, and the local environment.